For number one, part C, we have the f of u equals u squared over u squared minus 9. We're going to find the first derivative and the second derivative. Well, if you don't like the u notation, you can change it on your notes to be the f of x. It's more convenient. And then at the end, bring the u term back to the x expression. So not a big deal. Do it whatever that is comfortable for you when you work on a problem. All right, I guess the x version is more familiar with than the u, right? Okay, from this part, how would you like to find a prime?
I see a quotient rule in here.
Yes, very yeah. Obvious. Uh-huh. We're gonna use the quotient rule. What's the formula for the quotient rule?
Low D high minus high D low.
Low D high minus high D low, dotted line, low squared. Uh-huh. And mm-hmm. And what is your low and your high? Oh, your high first. The high is x squared. Okay. Oh, you if you want to keep the u, that's fine. You want to keep as a u form?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. So that means I'm gonna erase the original one then. I mean, I'm gonna erase this part. Okay, just follow your lead. So on the side notes here, so I named the top one as a high, the bottom one as a low. That's very yeah. Obvious, right? The high yeah. Is u squared and the low is u squared minus 9. So the d high is?
2u.
2u and the d low is?
Same 2U. Thing.
Uh-huh, 2u. And for the first derivative, use the formula, the low, D, high. I copy one more time. High, D, low, over, low squared. So the low is the quantity. Make sure you put parentheses around. U squared minus 9. The D, high is 2U minus the high, which is U squared, multiplied by D, low, which is 2U. All divided by the quantity of the bottom squared. Okay. We apply the rule. The next step always simplifying. All right, so go ahead, simplify the numerator and let me know what you get. So I'm gonna, I used your answer and then I'll show you I will show the class if anyone needs me to explain how to get the term negative 18 u. So we have negative 18 u. Everyone okay with the term negative 18u for the numerator?
Yeah.
Okay, good, good. All right, can we move on to the second derivative?
No.
Can we move on to the
yeah,
next
yeah.
One?
Yeah, yeah. I'm good, I'm sorry. But yeah, now
Min always said no, so I'm not sure.
No, no, it's yes.
All right, so I hope everyone is good with the numerator as negative 18u. Okay, so the next part, we're going to continue with the second derivative.
Wait.
I'm going to use different color. So what rule are we going to apply again?
Quotient rule.
Quotient rule again, because it's still in a quotient form. So the second derivative, we use the same formula. Low D high minus high D low, draw the line, low square. But this time, the high and low is different. The high is top and the low is the bottom. Okay, on my side notes, my high for this is negative 18u. The low is quantity u squared minus 9 power 2. The d high, very nice, that's negative 18. How about d low? What is the d low?
Yeah, 2 and in the parentheses u to the power of 2 minus 9 and in the parentheses and then multiply by u again.
Multiply by
2u.
2u. Yep. Or the d low is 2 and 2 becomes 4. 4 times u squared minus 9 as the nice order of the derivative. Okay. Thank you. So we get everything. We just bring everything back into the formula. The low, the quantity, u squared minus 9 squared. D high, negative 18. Subtracted by the high, which is negative 18u. I need more room, so I'm gonna adjust my space a little bit. So then my f double prime, the low u squared minus 9 squared, the d high is negative 18 minus the high, which is negative 18 u, and then the d low is the quantity 4 u times u squared minus 9, all divided by the quantity of the bottom squared, which is the square of the squared. Okay. Yep, we have more terms on the top. Yeah, I'll let you simplify the top and then let me know what you get. So you said u squared minus 9.
Oh, you mean the numerator, not
numerator.
The bottom, not the top?
No, the numerator means the top. The denominator is the bottom.
Oh, no, sir, no, I thought you talking
the
about.
The bottom is just the power 4.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So what do you get for the numerator, the simplified form of the numerator? Yes, we're gonna have the factor u squared minus 9. And then what would be the rest of them?
U squared. I think I got it.
U squared minus 9 again.
Ryan, would you like to share?
So we have to write.
Yeah, I think I do.
So we have to write u squared minus 9 2 times, right?
You don't have to do 2 times. Do you mean 2 factor?
Yeah, so you have to write 2 times. And
okay, think about factoring. So how about, let me read this one this time. So we have the common factor. I should use the highlight. So u squared minus 9, and also the power 2 out front here. Oh. And also another one that I will point out for you would be the negative 18. And negative 18. See what I highlighted in yellow and in blue, they are called a common factor. So that what I'm gonna pull it out from the whole group, from the entire group. So then my entire group, I already get like u squared minus 9. Another portion is negative 18. And then I make it as a bracket, just different notation to see the whatever inside of my bracket would be the leftover from taking the common factor out. Okay, I take one power out from the first one. So I still have u squared minus 9 left for the first term, for the first group. I consider this as one group together. This is another group together, okay? Right. And then the second one, the second term, I got negative 18 out and I got u squared minus 9. So then I still have u and u and also the number 4. That means I will have with the negative sign here, so minus 4 u squared as the leftover from the second group. Okay. With this, I see my common, my light term, u squared and negative 4 u squared, and also the u squared minus 9 power 1 and power 4. These two can be reduced to be the power 3. And these two terms can be combined to be negative 3 u squared. Okay. I'm going to move to the next slide by copying this stuff. I'm going to select. Let's see if I can manage this. Copy, Control C. And Control V. Where did it go? It doesn't come anywhere. I will write it out. So at this point, my F double prime in terms of U, right, equals the quantity U squared minus 9, negative 18. And in my bracket, I copy one more time. It's U squared minus 9 minus 4 U squared, all divided by the quantity U squared minus 9 power 4. And I combine light terms in the bracket here, that becomes negative 3 u squared. And then the power 1 and power 4 reduced to be the power 3. Now the top becomes negative 18. In the bracket is negative 9 minus 3 u squared. all divided by the quantity u squared minus 9 to the power 3. One more thing that I can do for this expression, I see the common factor 3 out of 3 and 9 with a negative sign. So be negative 18. Pull out negative 3, so then my bracket becomes 3 plus u squared, all divided by u squared minus 9 to the power 3. And then what else I can do, just simplify the product to be 54. And then the bracket here, you can write back to the normal parentheses, write u in the front, u squared plus 3, or leave it at 3 plus u squared, that doesn't matter. All divided by the quantity u squared minus 9 to the power 3 as the second derivative for this problem.